Shalom aleichem, rabotai. Shalom aleichem. Before we start, Bezat Hashem, I would like to give everyone a blessing. May Hakadosh Baruch Hu give everyone beracha netzlacha.
Amen.
Siyata d'shma gdola. May the merit of Rabbi Chaim Pinto and may the merit of Rabbi Moshe Aharon Pinto protect everyone and grant all the hearts wishes Bezat Hashem for the Yidikim.
Amen.
We know, rabotai, that Baruch Hashem today is a very special day. Today, actually, rabotai, it's one day before the ilula of my grandfather Rabbi Moshe Aharon Pinto. Now, rabotai, we know what the Zohar Kadosh says that 3 days, and I mentioned this in the past in previous ilulot. That 3 days before the Ilula itself, and 3 days after, the Tzaddik has the exact same strength like it is in Ilula. So it comes to a total of 7 days, where in these 7 days, we can all pray to the merit of Tzaddik, we can all light candles of Tzaddik, and with his merit, we can get all our heart wishes granted. So Abotai, today, we're already towards the end of the three first days. Abotai, I advise everyone Be'at Hashem. To go light a candle to Rabbi Moshe Aharon Pinto, to go light a candle to my grandfather, which Rabotai, we know all the miracles, we don't have to start to say all the miracles about Hashem, my grandfather, but we know Rabotai that Rabbi Moshe is more than capable to give us more than what we need. Rabotai, today, tomorrow, after tomorrow, we have a few days where we need to all take advantage. Go light a candle to Rabbi Moshe, and you know what? When you light the candle, say his grandson is asking for you to hear my prayers. That it is not, there's no moving left or right. We are demanding Be'at Hashem with his spirit to get Baracha. If we demand, we get what we want, Be'at Hashem. Amen. If we do it with intensity, we do it with strength, we'll get what we want, Be'at Hashem. Today, Rabotai, it is Tuesday. Now, we know, Rabotai, what it said about Tuesday, that first of all, we have what Sefirah? Tiferet. And Tiferet, Rabotai, we speak about it every week. It is one of the most powerful Sefirot that exist. That it is a Sefirah that it's not only that you are pulling down Bracha from it, it's not like all the other sefirot where you tap into the bracha and you pull down bracha, but you actually awaken the sefirah. You actually awaken one of the 10 lights of Hashem, and that light actually acts to bless you. That light actually acts to take upon a person, to bring upon a person big blessings. That is, Rabotai, very unique. How do we awaken the sefirah tiferet? By learning Torah, by spreading Torah, by bringing Emunah, by spreading Emunah, by inspiring one another, by doing more mitzvot, anything that we can do with the Torah, Kedushan, with the Emunah, that we do on Tiferet, and we have in mind to do it, to wake up the Tiferet, we wake up the Tiferet. Because what is a Tiferet? Tiferet is the suit of HaKadosh Baruch Hu. Where HaKadosh Baruch Hu dresses in the Tiferet in order to act in the world. So if we want to wake up the kindness of Hashem, we have to do it today. You know, Rabotai, it's about Yaakov Avinu, which we know that Tiferet is the day of Yaakov Avinu.
Yeah.
That every single day has its own forefather and its own Sefirah. Tuesday is Yaakov Avinu. We know it's about Yaakov Avinu. In Laban Garti, V'tarag Mitzvot Shamarti. That Yaakov lived with Laban Arasha, his father-in-law, and Rashi adds and explains V'tarag Mitzvot Shamarti. That I kept 613 mitzvot. That even though I lived with the biggest Rasha, Laban Rasha, what the Zohar says, lies there, what the Zohar says. The Zohar said that his specialty was whispering to the snakes. It was the worst of the worst, of the darkest tum'ah in the world. Laban was mastering it. Rashi says he lived by Laban and he kept the 613 mitzvot. Abu, I have a question. We know that Laban didn't live in Eretz Yisrael. Laban did not live in Eretz Yisrael, lived actually out of Israel. And we know about Tari that many of the mitzvot that are existing in the 613 mitzvot belong to what? Belong to mitzvot that need to be done and only can be done in Eretz Yisrael. Like Shvita, like Maasrot. That there are mitzvot that you cannot do outside of Eretz Yisrael. Like we are here in America, in Canada, where we can only do a certain amount of mitzvot. The mitzvot that have to do with Eretz Yisrael, we cannot do it. There's also mitzvot of Kohanim, of being a Kohen. There's mitzvot of kings. And all those mitzvot are counted in the 613 mitzvot. Now the question is, Rashi says that Yaakov Avinu kept all 613 mitzvot. How is it possible? If he wasn't in Eretz Yisrael, he didn't keep the mitzvot of Eretz Yisrael. He's not a king, he didn't keep the mitzvot of a king. He's not a Kohen, he didn't keep the mitzvot of a Kohen. Meaning that it's impossible that he kept all 613 mitzvot. So how is it possible, Rabotai, that we say about Yaakov that he kept all 630 mitzvot when really it's not true? So Rabotai, it's to teach us something that is very big. We say etzem limuda hu kiyuma. The fact that you study about it, the fact that you have the knowledge and you're studying the 613 mitzvot, it is like you are doing the 613 mitzvot. That just the fact of taking upon yourself a mitzvah, even if it's a mitzvah that doesn't apply to you, you say, the 613 mitzvot, the mitzvot that I can do, the mitzvot that I want to do, the mitzvot that I'm taking upon myself to do, just by doing that abotai, we gather the merit like we did with all the mitzvot. Where it says Nozoa Kadosh, where Kadosh Baruch Hu, he is very kind with, where he gives us our thoughts of mitzvot, that whenever we think about doing a mitzvah, he gives us the merit like we did the mitzvah. So Abotai, today on Deft If Eret, we should all take upon ourselves all the 613 mitzvot. We say from here and on, we look up to Hakadosh Baruch Hu, Hakadosh Baruch Hu, I want to take upon myself all 613 mitzvot. Just by doing so, Abotai, we will hold the merit that we did all the 613 mitzvot, and we will wake up the Tiferet in order to receive big beracha. So may HaKadosh Baruch Hu bless everyone. May the merit of Rabbi Moshe Pinto bless everyone. Amen. And may we all, Be'at Hashem, have a day full of beracha and big misiyata d'shmaya. Amen. Amen.